This is a series on home automation basics. I'll be covering some of the essentials like scenes and modes, automations, voice assistants, and how to secure your smart home devices. In the last video, I walked through geofencing and how to use that to automatically trigger different routines. If you haven't seen that one yet, I'll include a link in the description. You can also jump back one or two videos in the Smart Home for Beginners playlist. In this video, I'll be jumping into voice assistants, which is a fantastic way to make your smart home accessible to the entire family. While I will be giving examples from different systems like SmartThings, Google, Amazon, and others, this is meant to be a platform-agnostic view on home automation. These are core concepts, and they apply to no matter what system you're using. If you're just getting started, then this is the series to watch. If you're already building out your smart home, then this may still spark some ideas. Before we dive in, take a moment and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on the full series and other future videos just like this one. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. When it comes to smart homes, having voice assistants throughout your house can be extremely useful. In the previous videos, we walked through creating scenes, setting up routines to automatically trigger those scenes, and finally using geofencing to enhance those triggers. With voice assistants, it makes it incredibly easy to trigger any device, scene, or routine just by asking the house to turn it on or off. And while the automations we've already set up cover the vast majority of the smart home use, needing to manually trigger something in your home is unavoidable. Voice assistants make it easy for everyone in the house to take control of the house, all without having to fumble with a smartphone. Just ask to turn the living room lights on or to start cleaning the upstairs and have the Roomba kick off a cleaning cycle. You really have three choices: Amazon, Google, and Siri. And before anyone laughs at Siri or the lack of Bixby and Cortana, it really is just those three. Amazon, Google, and Siri are all capable voice assistants when it comes to smart homes. Cortana and Bixby? Does anyone actually use Cortana and Bixby? Amazon Alexa is the 800-pound gorilla of the three. Amazon has commoditized smart home speakers and used their storefront to push millions of cheap smart home speakers out to the masses. They're the undisputed leader for right now, and I'm sure many of you have settled on Amazon as the central pillar for your smart home setup. The beauty of Alexa is that it's widely adopted, and most smart home accessories have skills that you can link to your account. If you're linking Alexa to another smart home platform like SmartThings, Wink, Hubitat, you need to find that skill in the Amazon Skill Marketplace. Once you've linked the service, you'll see all of the devices associated to that service show up as devices with Amazon. If you tap into the devices section of the Alexa app, you'll want to set up different groups to have better voice control of those devices. I'd recommend creating groups based on rooms in your home just to start. Put everything that's in the living room in a living room group. The reason for that is that then you can ask Alexa to turn off the living room lights and it will just work. And if you have created an Amazon routine, which we talked about in the second video in the series, then you can call out the name of the routine to Alexa to trigger. Google Assistant is really the most natural and capable assistant of the bunch, but surprisingly, isn't really the best option as your central pillar for your smart home. You're better off using another service like Wink, SmartThings, Home Assistant, or Hubitat as the central pillar, and then tying Google Assistant into that service. Regardless, issuing voice commands to control your smart home works just like you'd expect. Setting it up with third-party services is a lot like Amazon. In the Google Home app, you tap the Add button, then Set Up Device, then Have Something Already Set Up. You can link it to services like SmartThings, Hubitat, and more. And just like Amazon, when they're added in, you need to manually sort the imported devices into different rooms and groups. Once sorted, you'll be able to issue the same exact verbal commands to turn on and off devices by room, group, or device type. You can also trigger any routines you've set up just like Amazon. Apple Siri is another capable option for voice assistant control of your smart home. And I can hear some of the Google and Amazon fans chuckling right now, but it's true. Siri is more than capable at the basic smart home controls. And with iOS 13, Siri will be gaining even more abilities. That said though, at the moment, not every device works with Apple's HomeKit natively. If you have something like a Logitech Harmony remote, you can easily tie that into both Amazon and Google for voice control of your home entertainment system. That's not possible with Apple out of the box. You have to use a separate system called HomeBridge to make non-HomeKit devices usable by HomeKit and Siri. I won't be diving into that in this video because it's too much to cover, but just like the other two, you can ask Siri to control devices by name, routine, as well as scene. All three systems at their core behave the same way with linked devices, scenes, and routines. In the next video, we'll be diving into security, which is a very important topic. Drop any questions you have in the comments, and let me know if you're taking advantage of voice assistants in your home. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends because it really does help the channel. There are some other ways that you can support the channel too. Check out my SFSF shop for some cool Tesla, SpaceX, Science, and Undecided t-shirts. There are other links in the description for some great Tesla accessories and discounts. And as always, an extra big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. Your support is really helping to make these videos possible. Be sure to check out my Patreon page for additional details about joining the crew. If you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell to get alerts when I post new videos. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.